continuation, the next project. I just want to make sure that the mic is doing what it's supposed to. Awesome. Okay, cool. So, we're doing S2D7 Brown Mountain. This is part 3. Good. And let's see where we roam. Okay, scratching some stuff.
All right, now with a clean, dry, wind brush, I'm just going to begin.
You know what? I want to put on some Holst. I need to get the... third. Holst is epic.
Gently lift it up. Just lift it up. I'll do this in a
little bit. All right.
There we go. Add a little bit of camera to the brush. I'm frightened.
There's a timer going, so I know what time I'm spending. Yeah, he's got that yellow going on.
Yellow. Just pop it in. And you bend the bristles and pop it. Just right away. There we go.
Okay, interesting. Okay, so I don't need to screenshot that because I grabbed those color references earlier from coming into this space here and picking up these references here. So what I do need to do, though, is take these, my palette, drop these into my palette layers that are hidden. I'm going to collapse this into mountain. Just so I can make sure that I don't screw up the layer on my phone. Hit save, but it's super quick. Dramatic save music. Step aside. So I got the color I want. Let's find the brush I want. So the texturing brush I'm going to use, from watching what he's doing, I think this color is strictly in there to produce contrast, so that because the next thing we're going to be doing is laying in tree lines to separate to push the mountain back further. So I suspect that the color is being used just purely to help that color separation for your eyes. I mean, maybe the reason is the season that he wants the color in there because maybe it's like fall or something, and this tree's whatever it is, because I mean, yellow is not very natural. I'll just have to go fetch it again. So, boop, boop, boop. Zoom. Yeah. So, okay. So, he's doing vertical stuff. So, let's play with the vertical brush. That'll be fun. Let's see that. Ooh, man. That is dense. Too dense. All too close. Feels better. And angle that a bit. I'll drop that down here. Nice. That feels a lot more pleasant. Just whispering that on there. Thank you. Excuse me. Still getting over that cold, man. I'll tell you. Kicking pants. It's looking a little bit more textured the way I want it to. Soft. Feels a little more natural. Use a low opacity eraser here just to work on fading this in a little bit more. Cool. Okay, I'm quite happy with that at this point, so I'm going to leave that be. I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to move into Mountain Chalk. Contours. I should be paying attention to the contours. There we go. La-di-da. Photoshop magic. Here we go. Ah. And perfect. Grooves. So let's see here. So yeah, I wrote to the bottom here just preemptively, just to make it settle in a little bit more. And we'll come in the second one here, and we'll go with this. Actually, that feels better. Same brush, we'll remove texturing. And it should be 100%. So it's pushing the pixels around. There we go. Yeah, nice. Save. Alright, so that is pretty good. We're going to call that there. Now, I think what we're doing is we're getting into some tree line stuff. So let's do a screenshot for that. Copy here. Go into the palette. Oh man, that looks good. I love how that looks. That's fantastic. Let's come down here. Grab that color real fast. Not much going on with that. Let's see how this guy goes. You know, also since this is his brush. Tell you what, man, grabbing these little gripper tools here on the side is just obnoxious to me. Anyone knows a better way about that? All ears for a solution. There's gotta be a better tool than that. That's just the worst user interface design. I go back to the same brush here. Experimenting a little bit. I'm always experimenting. Okay. Except getting spacing. Sometimes I can bring it on purpose. Craziness. Now I'm going to drop down the opacity of the eraser here so I can stitch that in a little bit and pull it around. This always reminds me of the black hole. The old Disney movie. God, that movie was awesome. I loved that movie growing up. Watch it all the time. It was like when HBO was new, Disney Channel was new, back in the early 80s when cable was a new thing, and that was so much fun. Playing my Legos, listening to the black hole on Disney. So fun. Stop mincing on this here for a second. I can just play with this stuff all day. I really shouldn't. So, what's next?
So let's just start making these little indications with a fan brush. It's a good way to make a lot of trees real quick. You see trees way off in the distance. You don't see a lot of detail.
Neat.
You make out basic colors and basic shapes, but that's all. You knew that, though, I know. Okay, maybe this climbs right on up here. Maybe there's a nice little hill here.
Okay. So, I'm gonna get up and do that again. Group those together so I don't have to mess with that again. Then here, see how easy it is to cheat here. Good. Here's my cheats. Skew. Pull that down. Yeah, like that. Save button real quick, grab a sip. Remove that spacing. Huh? Good. Okay. And then we're going to come back in with this brush. And we are going, I think this is an appropriate tool to use right now. And that guy up real good. Nope, too dense. Switch out to this tool here. Ah, I forgot what the spacing take is up. There. See, that took almost no time at all. Such a great tool. It's been a while since I've had to do it. Doing all these winter pieces, I haven't had a chance to work with this brush for a while. I missed it. This is fun. Such a fun brush. So much fun. That was awesome. All right, so we're gonna texture this stuff up a bit too. We're gonna new layer. Just lay in some of this here, and then we'll just rough it up a bit. Just kind of let it. Again, we're creating an illusion of detail, and that we're letting our eye come in and fill in a lot of these gaps and pieces that we're working on. It's allowing your eye to define what that texture actually is. Is you're letting the eye use your own library of knowledge of how things are in the world, and allowing it to translate what these marks mean. What is it that I'm producing here? Your eye fills in the answers for that. So it's our job to create enough texture and action in here so that it's easier for your eye to answer those questions. That's the fun. Finding ways to be able to produce those results with minimal effort, efficiency, and make it look good in the process. So much fun. So much fun. Look at that. That is so much fun. How long have we been going at? Alright. That's probably a good place to stop. Let's see what he's got going on here real quick. Yeah, look at that. Nailed it. Nailed it.
Maybe there's a few evergreens here that are a little bit closer, so they're going to be a little bit more distinct. So maybe there's one right here. Okay, touch. And just begin nailing a little tree.
Okay. Closer, so a little more detail. Let's see before he goes on this real fast, because yeah, I think he's... Okay, yeah, we're going to just go ahead and stop here. He's going to call this.
A magic one. A little bit here. He's a little closer. Right here. Touch. And just begin nailing a little tree.
Neat. Okay. Well, yeah, we're just going to go ahead and cut here. Fun. Fun. All right, folks. I'll catch you tomorrow. Cheers.